freezing temperatures in the forecast, it's time to harvest the last of the tomatoes from our field trial beds and answer the question, did rock dust and biochar increase our yields in 2014? If you've been following the trials, you know that we've been growing the same crops in three identical 4x4 garden beds, filled with the same base mix of compost and worm castings. The rock dust bed was amended with 1 pound of rock dust per square foot. The biochar group was amended with 0.5 pound of charged biochar per square foot, and the control group had no additional amendments. All season long, we've been weighing the produce from all the beds in order to test the claims that rock dust and biochar produce greater yields. As of our last update in early September, the control group had the highest total yield, with 15,300.2 grams. The biochar group had the second highest yield, with 14,132.2 grams. And the rock dust group had the lowest yield, with 10,156.2 grams. At the time, I suspected that the biochar group might end the year with the highest yield thanks to its outstanding tomato production. So now that all the crops have been harvested, I thought I'd share with you the final totals. I'll start with a very modest pepper harvest. Since the last update, the control group pepper harvest increased from 96.4 to 187.1 grams, and the rock dust pepper yield increased from 0 to 48.2 grams. Now let's move on to the more substantial tomato harvest. Since the last update, the control group yield increased from 7,277.3 to 10,242.7 grams. The rock dust tomato harvest increased from 3,868.3 to 5,790.4 grams. And finally, the biochar group yield went from 8,592.7 to 13,168.3 grams. So as I suspected, the biochar group's strong tomato harvest gave the group the highest total yield with 18,707.8 grams, just barely edging out the control group by 351.5 grams. If like me, you're more used to thinking in terms of pounds and ounces, that's a difference of only 12.4 ounces. Though the biochar and control groups were very close, the rock dust yield was substantially less at 12,126.5 grams. That's 34% less than the control group harvest. So after the first year of our field trial, the results don't support the hypothesis that rock dust increases yields. And even though the biochar group had a slightly higher yield than the control, it wasn't significant enough to support the hypothesis that biochar increases yields. That said, we'll continue the trials another 2 years to see if the results from these amendments improve over time. Soon, Stephen Legarry and I will publish videos summarizing all of the field trial results from all participants. This will include taste tests, Brix tests, total yields from all participants, and Stephen's soil and plant tissue lab results. If you'd like to learn more about the trials, please see the link to the playlist at the end of the video and in the description below. And if you'd like to join or follow the trials next year, please join the Home Garden Field Trials G+ community. Well, that's all for now. Thank you very much for watching. And until next time, remember, you can change the world 1 yard at a time.